Welcome to Everyday Heroes. That's the series we're busy doing at this moment. And before I get into more of that, I want to speak for 1 minute about the hero support that we're doing today. And I want to name our heroes today as all single parents. To all of you who've worked hard and are working hard to give the best to your children and sacrificing for them and doing crazy work and hours, whatever, often being mom and dad all at once, I salute you as a hero. Single parent, you are a hero. And if you were raised by a single parent or know a single parent that's doing their best for you and giving extra time, making sacrifices, please make it your business today, right after this video, to call them, text them, email them, see them, get a flower, get chocolates, whatever, and just say thank you for your effort. You are my hero. I think that is special. It is not easy being a single parent, and we want to honor all the single parents out there. For the job you're doing, you're a hero. So, this message today is to encourage you to operate in the opposite spirit of what comes your way. This principle of standing and responding in the opposite way to how people will treat you or what life brings to you is easier said than done. I know that. Going with the flow in life is actually quite easy. But swimming upstream, I have found, is something else. To do that requires courage and conviction. And by the way, that's what defines a hero for me. It's people who will stand up, take courage, even if you feel weak, feel defeated, and you live from conviction. I believe that it's not going with the flow. It's part of what I want to address today. It's going contrary to popular opinion or agreeing to avoid conflict, but acting in a way that pleases God as an accurate reflection of his character and his attitude in the world. That's the opposite spirit. Jesus spoke about this in Matthew 5, verse 38 to 47, where he says, rather than just loving those who love you, how about loving those that mistreat you or treat you unfairly? And if somebody tries to take one thing from you, give them another with it. It's such a radical, different approach to life. And rather hate, give love. You see, this is not easy, and probably, if we're really honest with ourselves, impossible using our human strength and ability. But it is possible when you make a choice to be strong. Not strong in yourself or your opinion, but strong in your decision to let Christ lead your response. You may say, Francois, what do you mean by that? Well, let me use an illustration. I found the acronym WWJD very helpful in this regard. What does that mean? Well, it stands for What Would Jesus Do? And if you and I can pause long enough to ask this with every situation and person we face, I think it could have a very different outcome. You see, hate that's answered with hate breeds more hate. Rudeness met by more rudeness breeds more rudeness. But if you can let Jesus convince you that that ugly cycle can be broken by your acting in the opposite spirit, because that's how he would have acted, we can actually break that ugly, destructive cycle and stop it and ultimately change it. Ask yourself, WWJD, and you will be surprised what comes out of that. And once you've asked that and you've landed a conviction from the Lord that, well, maybe it's not the best thing to give rudeness for rudeness, but then ask Him to give you the strength and the courage to act in that opposite way. If you do that, you're a real hero. If you act in the opposite way, it may not change things instantly, but I can guarantee you from lots of examples I've seen in life that in the long run, it will. And Jesus Himself was a living proof of that. That when He was accused and ridiculed and threatened, He did not respond in kind, but He responded by forgiving. Wow! And that's why we have a Savior that conquered the cross, sin, death, hell, and today can present us with the hope to live a better life and live in eternity with Him. Thank you, Jesus, for that. So let me pray with you for the strength to act in the opposite spirit and be a real hero. Lord, I pray, help us not to respond to people and events in our own way and repay evil for evil, but rather to respond the way You would, and then by Your power to do it. Love for hate, forgiveness for accusation, kindness for rudeness. Help us, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.